In the United States, the United States Department of Agriculture, or the USDA, lays out regulations for how food products should be produced and processed to ensure food safety. The United States Food and Drug Administration, or the FDA, on the other hand, determines the best food consumption practices to minimize health problems. Ironically, they also determine how much rat hair should be allowed in peanut butter, rat feces in your spices, and cigarette butts in your sandwich. Unless you find more than 30 insect fragments or 1 rodent hair per 100 grams of peanut butter, 9 milligrams of rodent poop per 1 kilogram of wheat, 75 mites per 100 grams of dried mushrooms, 1 maggot per 100 grams of tomato juice, and 13 insect heads every 100 grams of fig paste, the FDA expects you to compromise with the situation because, well, no food practice is perfect, humans make mistakes, restricting food laws will increase food prices, and bugs aren't that gross. Some of them are quite healthy. At the same time, the USDA has laid out guidelines for how commercial eggs should be produced, processed, and stored to make sure eggs remain safe for public consumption. The UK has their own regulations, but their regulations are quite opposite to those in the US, making it illegal for eggs produced in the UK to be sold in the US and those produced in the US to be sold in the UK. But if guidelines in both the cases are made for food safety and are in the public interest, why are they so contrasting to one another? Which of them is the right practice, or are both of them equally good? In the case of American eggs, the USDA requires its egg farms to properly wash and sanitize their eggs before they reach consumers in order to remove any dirt and feces on the exterior of the eggs. These contaminants are bacterial in nature and may pose a food safety threat when they enter a kitchen environment. For instance, one may crack open an egg and then proceed to prepare a sandwich with those bacteria-ridden hands. Also, eggshells are porous, so there's a possibility of microbes leaking inside the egg. As per the regulation, eggs are washed with warm water, at least 20 degrees Fahrenheit warmer than the internal temperature of the eggs, and at a minimum of 90 degrees Fahrenheit. A detergent that won't impart any foreign odours to the eggs is also used. After washing, the eggs are rinsed with a warm water spray containing a chemical sanitizer to remove any remaining bacteria, and then are dried to remove excess moisture. Every step of this whole process is scientifically designed and must be executed with extreme care, otherwise this procedure can lead to more damage than good. For example, the drying of eggs is crucial because a dry eggshell acts as a barrier to bacterial intrusion, while the presence of moisture makes the shell more permeable, exposing it to a pathogen attack. Furthermore, moisture itself may act as a medium for bacterial growth, and water provides an excellent vehicle for pathogens such as salmonella. The right temperature of warm washing water is important because water colder than the egg could cause the contents of the egg to contract, sucking polluted water in through the shell. Results may get worse if a facility is not careful enough to regularly change the washing water and eggs are left to sit in the dirty bath. With such high risk of bacteria, if cleaned improperly, the UK and almost all of the world except the US believe that eggs should not be washed or cleaned before they're sold to consumers. As far as dirty eggs are concerned, the EU's egg marketing law encourages good husbandry on farms. Because eggs can't be cleaned or washed, it's in the farmer's best interest to produce the cleanest eggs possible, as no one is going to buy their eggs if they're dirty. This may not sound too convincing to you, but there's more to it. An egg carries a thin layer of coating on its outer surface called cuticle. This layer naturally protects eggs from almost all contamination and also keeps the eggs fresh for longer periods. Washing eggs damage most of this protective layer and makes them vulnerable to contamination from pathogens and other microorganisms. In the absence of washing, an egg is capable of protecting itself naturally, and if care is taken while handling the eggs, the contamination of kitchen environments can also be eliminated. The UK, thus, believes that a little care is better than the huge risk and cost of washing eggs. Another thing that makes British eggs and American eggs different to one another is how they're stored. In the UK and almost everywhere in Europe, you can see eggs sitting in unrefrigerated shelves of supermarkets. The EU regulations stipulate that eggs should in general not be refrigerated before selling to the final consumer. Chilled eggs, when left outside at room temperature during transit between the supermarket and the customer's home, may sweat and form moisture on its surface, facilitating the growth of bacteria and probably their ingression into the egg. The American system, on the other hand, instructs its seller to refrigerate eggs under 40 degrees Fahrenheit in order to decrease the risk of salmonella. Salmonella isn't a big problem in the UK because European farmers have been vaccinating their hens against salmonella since the 1990s and have received good results. Vaccination in the US is not a common practice. Because of all of these differences in how eggs are processed and stored in the two nations, British eggs are significantly richer in taste. But how would you know? British eggs can't be sold in the US, and the US ones in the UK.